Good morning, children. How are you all of you? I wish you a very happy new year. And so, as we begin the new year, we will also begin our studies. And with the introductory of a new chapter. Do you see here what I have written? It is the introduction to artificial intelligence. Yes, the most top topic. We have discussed several times about this. You are aware with this, and you are actually living with this technology of AI. In short, we call this AI. In short, AI. Now let's discuss what is the concept of AI and what was the necessary for its introduction. See children, we all work on computers, and you have seen that when we compare humans with computer, we have seen that computers are far better in doing complex calculations than us, isn't it? Then it can also work tediously, means continuously it can work. If I started working since morning, it can go on and on till continuously for even 5-6 days or even for years. But that humans cannot do. But whatever the things computers can perform, but somehow in one way computers are superior than, humans are superior than computers. That is the ability to decision making. Right? So this is what makes us all humans separate from the machines or computers. Right? Because humans gather their past experiences, from there they create logic and try to solve a problem. Okay? So by decision making, what is the, they solve a problem. But listen, in earlier time it was not possible by the computers to decide. Now the idea behind, the concept behind artificial intelligence is that we want to transform. If the computers can perform continuous work, then why can't they be made also decision making? They can be imposed the idea or intelligence of human to machines. Okay? Machines. This imposition of intelligence to the machines is nothing but this concept is known as AI, artificial intelligence. We want the computers to learn in a similar way that humans learn. Okay, so we are transforming our intelligence today so that they can assist humans in the near future, because the world is moving in a very faster way. So for that way, we require machines, fast working machines, and those who can make decisions just like humans. Okay, so let's discuss, take out page number 137, everyone. Okay, here you check out and find out the definition of artificial intelligence. Okay, this is the technology for the future, is it? So we are having an exciting time while reading this chapter. See, what is artificial intelligence? It is the ability of a machine to perceive its environment and take decisions in order to achieve a definite goal. Okay, see, like how humans perceive the environment with the help of eyes, with the help of ears, we have 5 sense organs to perceive our environment. Similar way, the machines can be made to perceive the environment and make decisions gather the decision out of it. Okay, now see, just check out this diagram. There are two cars here. Okay, do you see? Well, there is one white car, another is black car, right? This black car is run by human. Okay, there's a driver in it. Okay, now this person, how he runs or moves the vehicles? First, he perceives the environment around himself with the help of his eyes, ears, whatever he gathers information, put this in brain. Okay, the brain processes the information and the brain will order the hands and feet to move the cars accordingly. Okay, this is how the humans perceive the things and does the decision making or work. But this same similar pattern can be installed in the help in AI. Like in this car, there is no driver inside, but you can see there are so many cameras attached with it, so many sensors attached with it. The cameras, sensors, sense the environment, stores this in their CPU, and then CPU processes and takes and controls and moves the vehicles forward and backward. So this is how the artificial intelligence work. This is just a basic and simple idea of AI or artificial intelligence. Right? Now, what are we going to learn here? What are the various applications? Means, where are artificial intelligence used? Though it has a wide range scope of its applicability, but you can check this out on page number 135. That first we will discuss one by one the main areas where AI is being used. First, it is used in agriculture. How children see? Suppose if you have got an assistant. Okay, we are not aware that what a day or what weather forecasting will be tomorrow. It is just because of AI that we are able to detect what temperature, what weather can be tomorrow. So in this way, in a similar way, this forecasting can help the farmers to check or to see what kind of seeds can be sown and what kind of crops can be harvested. Okay, and then what period of time. So it helps them to predict the kind of seeds they can sow. Right? Next is healthcare. In healthcare, definitely this is the best area where AI is being used. You know, there are several diseases. Okay, I'm just giving a brief example of like in this COVID situation, how the doctors are able to manage the vaccination for COVID. It is just because of this AI. Okay, this AI assembles all the information that had long history of cold and cough in the past. From there, they have accumulated the information and they have seen that this can be treated by using some anti-inflammatory or this certain particular kind of medicines. From there, this with the help of AI, this COVID vaccination is being made possible. So that is how big companies or organizations, they are spending lots of money in AI so that they can develop proper healthcare structures. Okay. Now, next is artificial creativity. Though it has the human has mastery on it, artificial creativity. Though humans have mastery on creativity. What is creativity? Creativity means using our imagination and make something that is closer to reality. This is what humans are expert on. Now, what humans are trying? They are trying to pass the same similar creativity to the machines so that machines can perceive the surrounding and they can also make certain pictures, certain drawings, they can create music, videos out of this. Isn't it interesting, magical? Okay, the machine is performing our job, right? Now, you can see on page number 139, customer care, this is very important. Students have several times you have, if your phone network is jammed and you are trying to call the customer care center, then you will hear repeated messages or same messages again and again. That is because chatbots are installed there. So in customer care centers, these are the first places where the AI robots were installed. Okay, from there on you will see they can repeatedly make you engage in chat or conversation or in voice messaging, right? So, but yes, there they make use of NLP that we will discuss later. Now, next again we will discuss some more applications, that is in space exploration. Okay, where humans can't reach, machines can go and take out exact things with proper accuracy and clarity. Isn't it? You have seen that we had sent Mars rover on the surface of the planet Mars. Is it? But there no human could go. That machines can go and took accurate pictures on time and with clarity without food. Humans have to survive there with food. But this machines can survive only if they need scaling and constant energy. That's it. And they continue their work continuously. Right? Now, next application area is manufacturing industry. You have seen this several times in manufacturing. Like, in manufacturing industry, you have seen many arm boards. What we call that? Arm boards or robotic arms. Robotic arms are made here. They can continuously assemble the parts of a car, the parts of any product, while human cannot do this so fast. Is it, you know, with a huge demand of technology. So as the demands of products has increased, to supply that demand, robotic arms or robotic machines, not just arms, machines are installed so that the productivity can be increased. Okay, and the last one is hazardous exploration. Definitely, humans cannot stand down these nuclear explosions or hazardous explosions, right? So that can be, so instead of human, machines can be sent in place of humans to check or test the usability or applicability of the nuclear explosions, right? So these were the various application areas where AI are being used, though it has a wide scope applicability, right children? So your homework is that whatever we have discussed about AI and the application areas, you will make a list and learn this, okay? So your homework is for chapter 10, learn AI and its applications. Right children? So be prepared, do keep preparing this thing so that you utilize your time and use this time to learn it. Okay? That's all. Thank you so much children.